Hi everyone, in this video we are going to create a task controller, task services, all these things. And we will see, we are going to create a new module, and here we just move all these things to the core module. The filters, guards and interceptors, interface and pipes. Okay, and I can just remove the user module. I will be writing my other routes. Okay, so let's create another folder. Here I'm going to write task module. Okay, in the task module we will have a task controller, task service, basic DTO folder where we will define the data transfer object, and task module.ts. Right, so we will write our another different routes here. Okay, we will try to see how we can create the stored service and how we can create a basic task routes. Okay, so task service, what we are going to do in this is how to create a service. Simply export class task service. And this service should be injectable. We can just make this service injectable, and in this service I'm going to have a set of tasks is of type task array, and it is initialized with empty array. Okay, here we can create some interface. Interface will have all different tasks. Task name is of type string. Completed is of type boolean. Task is completed or not. Description is of type string, and owner is a user. Okay, owner is a string again, and duration of this task can be a number of hours. Okay, this is my task object. I will just import this in my service. Now I have all the different methods, so you can say this is a task store service. That will actually storing the number of tasks, so I can have all the different methods like public. We will try to write async methods here and try to write the controllers in the asynchronous way. Async add task. Okay, what it should return? It should return the promise of a particular task which you have added. Right? Simply if you return. Now add task, what you are going to return, you are going to first const tasks equal to, so you can just directly push in the current task object this dot tasks dot push the task method which you have received in the request payload. Okay, and what you can do is you have to return something. You can just return but you have to return okay so this is fine add task. Similarly, what we can do is all these store services methods, add task, get a particular task. Get task, here you will just pass the ID of a task, Here in the task interface, we can also have ID, which is of type string. It can be UUID for us. Okay, get task ID task, and here I will do this dot task dot filter. Or what you can do is, yes, filter should be fine. Const task, and we are doing this dot task dot filter. And in the filter, we are just checking the ID of that task should be equal to the ID which I'm getting. And here I can return the 0th index, right? Why it is complaining? I.id equal to ID which I am getting. Okay, so get task here at task. Get all task. So here you are returning simple this dot tasks. This is actually store service. Okay, it is returning the task array. But now this service can be injected to the task service, which actually going to talk to controller. So in this module, we are going to have two services. One simple task service. Okay, we can just copy these things in task service, so it will be very quick. But this will be just calling the another service to get the data. So here we are not going to have, we have a constructor injection of that service. Read only, and here I will be injecting this task store service. So let's rename it task store service. I'm exporting, and so this task store service I am injecting in my task service. It's done. Right now I can access this task store service to add a task. You can say when you are going to add task, so there should be a method add task, and it is taking just a task as an argument. So this is how you can actually inject one service into another. Get task, return this dot task service, task store service dot get a particular task, and we are passing the ID of type string. And get all tasks. Similarly, you can return that. So the objective of creating two services is just one is a store service, and one is just a normal service which is going to talk to our controller. Get all tasks. No, it is not accepting anything. So just remove this argument. Now this is fine. Now this task service you can inject into the controller. That controller will take care of calling this task service, and this is calling task store service. And we are using dependency injection, so we don't need to create the instance of these services which we are injecting. Now this task service can be injected in the task controller. So I can just write a simple controller just for showcase for now. Then we will extend this example to a different level. Private read only task service. Okay, here get all tasks. I will just show only single method for now, and it is returning. Sorry for the typo. Promise of task array. Okay, and it is async method. And here we are calling the task service dot get all task. So task we have to import. Now we can just see get all task, no arguments. Okay, now task controller, that is fine. So this is how we can achieve the basic dependency injection. We created a service, we created a controller. Now you are directly returning it, right? So it will automatically take care of the response code if you are returning any exception from get all to do's task or something. Like instead of doing this, if you are returning HTTP exception, like not found exception or internal server exception, then this task controller will automatically take care of throwing that exception instead of sending message. If everything is fine, we got the data, then it will send a status code 200 with the data. Okay. You can also override it with the express, like you get the request and response from the express, and you can access it using here res. Okay, res of response of type HTTP response that we are getting from express. Sorry, my bad. From express we are getting it. So you can just say response.json.send. This annotation we have to import. Here you can say response.status, which is okay, let's do 200.send this whatever we got in an array, right? So here we are getting const data equal to this dot task service dot get all task. In that case, you will not be able to return promises and all. Okay, simple. Here you are sending not data. This is like you have override this with the help of express implementation. Okay, that's it. In next video, we will extend it further.